So welcome to our 5:30 mentorship call, Forex in Heels. It's always a pleasure to have you on board. So we'll be doing this with, I think Innocent is saying hi. I think that's why his arm is up. Yeah, or you have a question? I don't know.
Hi.
Yes, I think he's saying hi.
Yeah.
Cool. Nice yes. to see you.
Nice to see you guys.
Yes.
I have some guest on form. She's called Rachel from Kampala, Uganda, and she's so much. She has a lot of energy like you guys. Eh?
So she's a guest?
She's a guest.
Okay. Remember, this is the mentorship call. She can sit in, but the guest presentation is at 7 p.m.
All right.
Yeah, but she can still sit in, just listen to what we do. And of course, she can also plug in again at 7 on the same ID.
All right.
Thank you. So welcome. I see Florence has joined us. Karibuni sana. So ladies and gentlemen, today we'll be talking about decision, which is on chapter 8. We're actually halfway the book because the book has 15 chapters. So we're almost home. So today we are talking about this. It's a very short chapter, but it's very heavy on information. So we'll just get to it. And of course, starting, there's actually an analysis that we are told over 25,000 men and women who had experienced failure disclosed that the lack of decision was near the head of the list of the 30 cause of failure. There's no mere statement of this theory. It's a fact. Ladies and gentlemen, think about it. Even when you're deciding on what to cook, sometimes we decide this, then when it's like 2 p.m., you're like, hey, let me check. So we tend that most of the times we are not very fast to make decisions. So you will find that we are not able to action what we want to do because we are very slow in making decisions. And this, again, it talked to me very, and actually what Napoleon Hill tells us in a nutshell, you look at people who are making over $10 million going up, they're millionaires. And I think this is also in the 5%, in the pie chart we keep talking about. These are people who make decisions like in a heartbeat. When they see an opportunity, they plug into it and learn. And I think it's Richard Branson or Warren Buffett who said, when you see an opportunity, say yes and get to learn when you're reading the opportunity. And that's why you'll find that most of these millionaires or trillionaires are able to make decisions very fast, and you'll not find them changing in between. No. And that's where you find, like, for example, like the Jason Browns in our academy, Akina, David Monitier, Bryce Thompson. If you listen to their story, they only went like for one presentation, signed up, and now look at them. They're Chairman 750. And also on the trading bit, I mean, once you decide that you want to do trading as the sole business in IAM, make a decision and say, I'll have a plan. This is what I want to do and action it. So, clearly, decision. And if we don't, and what Napoleon Hill emphasizes, the lack of decision is the major cause of failure. Lillian? You're muted, no?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, guys, we've been talking about this thing, decision, since the beginning of the book. And I keep on saying every time I read the book, it almost sounds like a repetition, like over and over. We are saying the same thing over and over. So it means that there's something that Napoleon Hill noticed about human beings, that we don't necessarily make decisions. And he felt like this was really, really key to literally, you know, just transforming our lives. So, I mean, there's so much I could say on that, but we've also just covered a lot of that in the last couple of weeks. And I think for me, where I want to just come in is bringing the example. There's an example that he talks about, like, for example, Henry Ford. For those people who know about Henry Ford was a kind of person who... He created this Ford company. It was very, very successful. I remember even a long time ago, we used to see Fords on the streets. Nowadays, we don't see them so much. But also, these cars were one of the best cars in their days. You know, by the time Henry Ford was coming up with this company, they were one of the most popular cars in the US. And the reason why Henry Ford was so successful was basically because he had a great habit of reaching decisions promptly. Like, you ask him something and he doesn't take time to think about it. And it says promptly and definitely, like finally, like he's made his decision, it's done, whether it's good or wrong. And that brings me to something that we've been learning also when I do my spiritual, you know, just reading the word and things like that. And we are told, even that King Solomon says in the book of Ecclesiastes that, you know, when it comes to life, and if you want to live a well-lived life, it's good for you to be able to make your decisions soundly. But the thing is, sometimes we take so long when it comes to making decisions, especially to do with money. Like now in Forex, we our decisions in Forex have to do with money decisions. Like you have to make a decision. Are you going to spend this amount of money to enroll into the academy or not? Are you going to end up eventually then spending an extra amount to trade with or not? Those are the constant decisions you keep on making. When you lose money in the markets, because it does happen, are you going to keep on staying in or not, you know? And in the Bible, it says, I mean, Ecclesiastes, it talks about the way that there are two, what you really need to concern yourself when it comes to making a decision is whether a decision is wrong or right, okay? That's where you need to kind of take time. But when it comes to making a left or right decision, just make the decision and then find out what's happening. Like Shiro has said, you know, if you make your decision, then you find your way down. Richard Branson says that a lot. I mean, jump in, make the decision. And usually, even now, I know some of us are on this call and we've had these things before, but I don't know if we make our decisions every day promptly, or do we take a long time mulling over a decision, deciding, okay, I want to do ABCD. I want to follow an educator. I want to become a master trader. I want to become a scalp. How long do we take to make those decisions? I want to hit a rank. I want to become a platinum 600. Are you still obsessed with the how? Like, how am I going to do it? How will I get there? Or are you just saying, yes, this is what I want to do, and I'm going to start making phone calls? Or do you start beginning to think, okay, how do I make my list? You know, how do I find the people who I'm supposed to talk to? You just made a decision that you want to hit rank. You don't need to think about the how. Just get started and do it. So for me, this, in terms of making your decisions promptly, and then he says that changing your mind slowly, you know, and Henry Ford was known for this, and he built one of the best car motor vehicle companies. Obviously, before now, it went down and everything, and those are just for other reasons. But for me, when I read this book, I was just like, you know what, this, make your decisions. And then also, it also brought in the perspective of opinions. Like sometimes you are so good at listening to other people's opinions, you know, and I'm sure Shiro will touch on that. I mean, we instead of making our own decisions, we are busy consulting. I mean, some of you will have heard about I Am Academy. By the time you decided to join I Am Academy, you had to consult. Sometimes you have to, inside you know that this is something I need to do, because you could go to your spouse and your spouse is like, no, Forex is not for us. But the question is, how is it not for us? It's for you. It's individual, you know. So that's also part of decision making. Like, you first have to have the answer to every question in your head first before you go outside, okay, and start consulting with other people who may not even have an idea of what your goals and dreams are. So I'll just leave it there as Shiro just takes us further.
Thank you, Lilo. I would also want to add on the opinion of us. You find that actually Napoleon Hill says, opinions are the cheapest commodities on this earth. And everybody has an opinion about everything. And that's why, personally for me, like when we do a presentation and then you hear somebody saying, I'm going to consult my uncle. Is your uncle a Forex? I'm just asking. I mean, and I know even this, example has been given by BK, who's doing his presentations. For example, if you want to go and buy a house and you call has consult, okay. Of course, you're going to ask, may I speak to da-da-da-da, and somebody says, oh, I'll give you Miss Lillian, who has been in the organization for 20 years. She has a house is worth $100 million. And then of course, I'm sure you as a person, you want to listen to the person and make a decision out of that person. But most of us, even in life, even like if I want to get married, why am I going to talk to somebody who's dated like 10 men and I'm going to look for their decision about marriage? no ways, I'm going to go to a person probably who's been married 20, 25 years. And that's the same thing, so that I'm able to make a decision. So again, if you are influenced by the opinion of others, you will have no desire of your own. If all the time you want to do something, but for example, I want to trade a big account, but I'm going to somebody who trades with a small account, surely, what is that person going to tell me? If I want to build big, who am I looking at? Am I going to talk to the 2,000, 5,000, so that I can know exactly what they have done to get there? So what Napoleon Hill tells us, stop taking people's opinions, just stop it. And that is why, again, he also comes back and tells us about your mastermind group. And he says, this is such an important group. Remember, once you're choosing a mastermind group, and this is a conversation we actually had with you, who is in your group? Are you in the same wavelength? Are you on the same vibration? Are you thinking the same? Is your mindset the same? Because remember, again, in the organized planning in chapter 7, we talked about that once you want to do it, once, of course, you come up with your plan, action plans, you have to check with your mastermind. So you have to be very careful who is in your circle. And ladies and gentlemen, one on this call and is on Instagram, look at Akina Justin Owens, who is in his mastermind group. Look at Chairman 100 Kwenda Ju, and look at them in the same rank. You see these guys almost driving the same cars, living almost in the similar houses. Why? Because these are the people who the opinions they have. So stop buying. Like, I know I have done this present. Then you'll hear somebody saying, I'm going to YouTube. Where in God's green earth would you be talking, going to YouTube about Forex trading? These are recorded videos of 2016, 2017. Here we are telling you, you're going to be mentored by Dr. K, who personally for us, we have seen her grow in the same academy. She's a seven-figure Forex trader. Why would I go to YouTube for crying out loud? I mean, why would I let the opinions of others? Because no, actually my friend told me Forex is a scam. Is she in it? And you're very, very loud to say, yeah, it's a scam. You've not even tried. You've not even tried the same Forex, but you're buying into people's opinion and saying, no, it's a scam. Network marketing is not. And I also don't appreciate when people say that network marketing is a scam. And for me, when I look at it, look at an organization. I came from corporate. There's a CEO. There are two managers. There's the salespeople. They're the people probably who are assistants. Isn't that a network setting? Is that a scam? But if you realize those kind of organizations, really you'll never get to the top. You're not going to be paid enough for your money. So Napoleon Hill is so adamant of let us not buy people's opinion. Because at the end of the day, everybody has an opinion. Even people even don't know how to drive a car. They'll give an opinion on spares of a car and very confidently say, Apana, the best car to buy is Toyota. Nahana, why are you talking to me about car if you don't have a car? Why are you talking to me about a property in Karen? You've never lived in Karen, telling me no, Karen is he has thieves. The land is escalated. So what we are being told by Napoleon Hill, get opinions from people who actually are in the same race with you. Yeah, I think Lilo, for me, that's what I would want to talk about. Yeah.
Yeah, and then, you know, and he says it so well. He says, you have a brain and a mind of your own. Use it. And I remember when I was reading, I was just, you know, things that I was capitalizing. And one of my pet peeves sometimes is, I usually say, a lot of people, we are not very, it's not very easy for us to think for ourselves. And, you know, because of the way we have been raised and everything, we've always been taught to seek counsel. And yes, counsel is important. And that's where the mastermind group comes in. That's where your spiritual mentors, your business mentors come in. But remember, these are mentors. You know, this is where things like praying also comes in. You're seeking a higher power for your decision making. So you're not necessarily just going to anybody. You know, and he says, you do not need to. And then another point he says on that, he says, you don't need to reveal what you know to everyone. Okay. Which for me was profound. Yeah. Because it says, keep your eyes and ears open and your mouth closed. So every time you're going out there to seek opinions and everything, you should more so likely, you know, watch what other people are doing, listen more. Yeah. And talk less. Because you find that the more you're engaging and talking and giving opinions, and especially as leaders, you know, sometimes we bring people into the team and then you advise them, follow Dr. K. okay? Then someone starts following Dr. K. Then before you know it, because you had Lilian Okado said Ballet Granville is awesome, you tell them now it's time to go to Ballet Granville. And they've not yet finished, yeah, learning everything they need to learn about Dr. K's strategy. So right there, in as much as all these people are amazing educators in our community, you're confusing your sign up. You're confusing the person you have told that Forex works. I mean, today I was talking to somebody. In fact, I just told him, you know what, I have a call, I'll talk to you later and give you counsel, you know, because he's in the Canada. Yeah, he's in Canada and he's so frustrated. And I could feel his frustration because he feels like, you know, he's been getting so much information. There's no, you know, there's no solidity in terms of how he's learning. And that's the thing, listening to opinions. And listening to opinions means that you're always changing your mind. And that's what Napoleon Hill says, stop changing your mind all the time. Like, at some point in time, you need to just say, okay, this decision, by the way, it's a left or right decision. Okay, if I go left, let me just go left. Until now, you know, at a point I'll be like, okay, maybe this left is the wrong way. You know, it's very evident, but you'd rather be on that journey on your own on the left, okay? Learning that one strategy, okay? Rather than being here left, then right, you know? So for me, that was really cool because I was like, you know what? Keep your ears and eyes open and your mouth closed. And then he says, also, there are a lot of envious people around you. Okay, when you just talk, people are picking up what you're saying, and the ones who are envious are probably, you know, praying against your prayers, or they're going to follow through on your ideas. You're just talking, you know. So he says that wisdom is quiet and silent. And you know, and he says he also put something which I put in bold: tell the world what you intend to do, but first show it. So first show it. Like for me, I was discussing with Shiru today and I was saying my decision right now is I'm just going to quietly trade. You know, I'm no longer going to be talking about, you know, how I'm trading and all that. I'm just going to trade and prove that this thing works, because there are a lot of people who are still in our community and still think, hey, there's no money in Forex because they're not making significant income, you know. So for me, that was something that, you know, was really cool, that, you know, tell the world what you intend to do, but first show it. So Shira, I don't know if you have anything else to add on that.
I just want to add one thing, and something else that Napoleon Hill tells us: if you talk too much to someone of your plans, they may just beat you to it. So as of course we are told, don't go around yapping around. Just grow in silence. Do your thing. And then voila, Lilo has bought a house in Lavington, Kitusuru, or wherever. Because there are people, again, who don't have good intention for you. So the more you are sharing, you may just find, again, they are envying you. And then, of course, applaud your defeat. Because, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, we are all traders on this call. We sometimes the trade just go, haywire. You want to give up. You're thinking, man, what is this decision I made? So sometimes, imagine just be quiet about everything. And everything is going to be in place. And then he also talks about courage. Okay. When you're making a decision, you have to be so courageous that, and stand firmly. Like today, again, I was speaking to Lilo. Sometimes we are not courageous enough to come out of a trade because we are scared. Okay, I may come out and then it goes back in my position. It's okay. Do you realize that the market is open for 24 hours, 5 days a week? So be courageous enough and say, you know what, I'm making a decision to jump out. Tomorrow is a better day. It has hit my stop loss. It is okay. And I'm happy, like, when our educator came yesterday on the call and he said there's even a trade signal he gave, it hit stop loss there, and okay. So we have to be courageous enough to make those decisions. And sometimes, in fact, what Napoleon Hill says, like Lincoln, it becomes it may even be because a death or something, that like Lincoln had to make a decision to, of course, free the blacks, and what happened, he died eventually. But you have to be courageous enough, stand on your decision. It doesn't matter what your accountability partner says. And again, ladies and gentlemen, get a person who you're on the same wavelength, who is encouraging you, who is encouraging you to make that decision. And again, also something else we are talking with Lilo. Are we courageous enough to change our lot sizes? Or are we still very timid, staying at 0.01? Your lot could be at $500. Why are you at 0.01, surely? Be courageous enough, go for 0.05. You know, because at the end of the day, the market is here to with us. It found us here. We are going to leave it here. Our kids will find it here. So be very, very courageous. Courage and decisions go very hand in hand. Lilo?
Yeah. And just to add to that, like, sometimes your decisions will require great risk. I mean, when you made the decision to get registered with IAM, that was a risk. I mean, Forex is a risky industry. By the way, statistically, and I don't want to scare anybody, but statistically, most of the people who get into Forex, by the way, they don't last more than a year. That's 93%, I think. I mean, the statistics are not awesome. So you guys, we are 18 on this call. In a year's time, majority of you guys will not be in Forex. You'll probably give up. And I'm not saying this in a bad way. I hope that you're going to prove me wrong, but I'm just saying that because I've seen it. I've been here for 20 months. I mean, we keep on saying with Shiro, we are still Shiro, myself, Bernard, from the original team that was here in 2018. So this is exactly a year later. So chances are, same thing here. You guys might move on to other things, which is fine. But I want to just give you this perspective in my own whatever. When I took the risk to join this company, and for months, I was losing money in the market. I was losing big. Guys, you guys know me. I'm an aggressive person in general. I go big or I go home. That's my personality. And so you can imagine, coupled with a lot of financial challenges, just how big I was going. I remember, I think it was June of last year, and I was telling people, I think I had blown like seven accounts. Some of you have blown maybe one, or maybe you've lost it. I don't know. I'm not saying that you should blow my accounts like that for it to make sense. No, I'm just saying that didn't stop me. That didn't make me feel, oh, now Forex doesn't work. I'm not going to be there. Because if I hadn't gone through, I mean, where else was I going? Without Forex, what else was I going to do? And that's some of the things you guys have to ask yourselves. If this doesn't work, what else are you going back to? Some of you, maybe you have plan Bs. I don't have a plan B. Even my writing business, I put it on hold. For me, writing is going to be my retirement plan, in terms of I want to write in peace by the sea, by the ocean, enjoying, not for pressure, you know, because that's how writers we are. We are creative. We need a good environment. But for me, in terms of income generation right now, what else am I going to do at my age if it's not Forex, you know? So for me, this is why I take the kind of risks that I take. And guess what, guys? Today, I'm a master trader, and I'm very confident to be able to say, I look at the market every day. I look at it, and sometimes I smile to myself. I'm like, we're going to make money here, you know? And I was talking to Shiro today, and I was trying to give her a plan of how we can grow as traders. And I was just telling her what I've been doing the last couple of days and how happy and excited I am about it, because I'm like, it's game over, you know, with this industry. So, and just to touch on what Shiro said about Lincoln, Abe Lincoln, one of the famous presidents of the US. I mean, he did a speech called the Proclamation of Emancipation. Okay. And this proclamation is what freed the colored people in the US. And guess what? He did that. He made that speech knowing that he had very close friends, okay, politicians who, you know, were going to be against the freedom of the colored people, okay, or the black people in the US. But he still made that decision, and he went and he did a speech. I'm going to ask you guys a question. How bold are you about your business? How bold are you about, let's say, for example, trading? You know, when you go into the market, are you going scared? Or are you going and saying, you know what, I'm going to free myself, you know, from the shackles of poverty, and I'm going to enter this trade with my 2 feet in? When a master trader gives you a trade idea, or an educator gives you a trade idea, and it goes the opposite way, do you retreat and disappear? And then you're like, I can't trade with Lilo anymore. I can't trade with Dr. K anymore. I can't trade. What do you do? Like, how brave are you about owning your decision? You owned the decision that Forex works. Why then, during a difficult time, do you retreat? If Abe Lincoln had not done that speech, guess what, guys? The coloreds would still be not free, you know? And yes, it cost him, okay? In the end, it cost him his life, you know? He lost his life because of that decision. So how brave and courageous are you? Like, what is at stake for you right now? what is at stake for you. If you don't have anything at stake, by the way, you're wasting time. And I'm telling you this with a lot of love. You're wasting your time, because in 6 months, I can tell you, you're not going to be here. So you need to have your stakes very high. Like it's all or nothing. All or nothing. So Shiru, I don't know if you have anything to add on that. And yes, that's basically it. I don't want to add more because I can see the time.
Just to end the call, Napoleon Hill actually states that indecision is a habit that we normally get from our youth. Right from there, when it's again how we are conditioned in our mind. And that's why you find most of the people who are even employed are in jobs that they don't even like, because you settled for less, because you didn't stick to your decision. If you wanted to be, for example, to be a doctor, okay, and then you realized, you know what? It's so hard for me to get admitted to a hospital. I can become, a pharmacist. He keeps saying that we have to uncondition our minds. And of course, the parents on this call and those of us who are aspiring, I think we have to condition our kids' minds or whoever else that we are mentoring, that you have to have a habit of decision. Then that way you just grow up knowing that this is what I want to be. And even like, once you realize like your child is exposed to making their own decisions, you'll find even though you push them to do something, they're like, no, I think I want to do business. I do not want to be a lawyer, because you've already conditioned this child's mind that it is okay to have a habit of decision. And let's make decisions very promptly and firmly. Let's not have our friends or family members actually sway our decisions. Because he actually even says family, I think, is one of the biggest deterrent in terms of decision, because they have the most decision, like, no, you're what do you know? Listen to me, as you've been here before, I've been on this earth for 70 years, what are you telling me? So again, decision for me was another very, very instrumental chapter when it came to think and grow rich, because you're able to apply it all around at your workplace, business, family life. So basically, you know, for me, I don't have anything else to add in terms of...
Yeah, awesome. I think for me, what I'll wrap up by saying is just reading something that I wrote down. It says, the person who makes a definite decision to pay the price, I mean, does not stake his life on that decision. He stakes his independent decision on his economic freedom, his desirable business and professional positions. That's basically, it's not really about the decision. It's basically, what are you willing to lose or gain because of a certain decision? So when you make whatever decision, in terms of even now doing this business, basically you're just saying you want economic freedom, you want professional freedom, you want to have a desirable business. So anytime that you're doing this business, guys, I just want you to take it seriously. Especially, I know there are people here, for example, who, you know, they, you know, one time they're in the academy, another time they're not in the academy. One time they're paid their monthly fee, another time they haven't paid their monthly fee. I just want to bring it home. I know it's financially sometimes training for people. And, but I can tell you, for me, when I made the decision to get on board, I didn't even think about the future. I was like, okay, let me look for the money for now. Okay. But I knew mentally, I knew it would take me a while. Yeah. So I purposed and I said, every other month, I'm going to ensure that I can still have access to the academy. Because at the end of the day, when we go to school and we spend so much time learning, guys, I did social sciences, I did government and public administration. Do I look like a government and public administrator? You know, it's akin to political science, you know. In these other universities. That's what I did. Of course, maybe I'll be a politician in the future. Who knows? But none of that for 16 years, you know, none of that really I'm using right now. Maybe the analytical bit of it, maybe the research bit, because there's a lot of reading that I used to do. Maybe that has helped me. But right now you're learning a skill that really can help you. How much are you spending time in the academy? How much are you spending time building your business? Talking to people about I am, you know, what decision did you really make? When you say that you really, really, really want to hit a rank or you really want to become great, Is that just something you say to make everybody happy? You know, even on our Friday calls when Bernard is talking about, you know, so say, what round do you want to? Sometimes I'm like, okay, Bernard, maybe we shouldn't ask guys, because sometimes people out of pressure, they make those decisions, you know, but deep down, it's not their decision. So I'll just invite you guys, this chapter is really important. Decision-making is important. Definite decision-making, not wishy-washy, changing your mind all the time. I'll just encourage you, just go back, you know, go back on your own, sit down and ask yourselves, re-look your decisions again, and then look at them on the side and say, okay, what should I be doing every single day to achieve that decision? Even if you do one thing to achieve your end goal at the end of the day, it's better than not even having a plan, okay? Because he also says that these things are not for the people, these things in reference to financial freedom, economic freedom, desirable businesses and all that, these things are not for the people who do not expect, plan and demand these things. Guys, we need to demand wealth. We need to demand success, you know? So I'll just end it there. And I just want to thank you guys for being on this call as always. Thank you, Shiro, as well. Next week, we'll be covering a different topic. We are almost done with this book. I know it's long. But I'll just encourage you, go back, look for this book, and just start reading it on your own. It has a lot of amazing nuggets. So yes, thank you. This is the end of our Forex in Heels edition. I hope you get value. Even if you don't, put it in the chats. Let us know how to to help your lives in future. We appreciate the criticism, positive or negative, but thank you so much. And the guys from Uganda, Asanteni Sana. For the guests who are not members, we are here at 7 p.m. We'll be doing a presentation for our guests, and we hope that we'll be able to bring them into this family as well. So thank you so much, Shiro. I don't know if you have anything to say, but I'm done and I'm out. Thank you.
No, I mean, you're the talker in this relationship, so that's okay. So I think we are good to go. So thank you very much and see you all at 7 p.m. of course, with your guests, and of course, we are going to close them. So thank you very much. See you here at 7, bang on time. Thank you.